Pay for performance is about linking pay, being either the evolutions in fixed pay or the variable pay, the bonus, to performance. Performance being either the performance of the individual or, let's call it, the more collective performance. Why should you go for pay for performance? Well, in fact, there are two perspectives and two reasons. Firstly, from a company perspective, pay for performance sends a very clear signal on the strategy and the objectives of the firm. So there is a clear form of strategic alignment. Secondly, from the perspective of the individual, pay for performance has a strong impact on the people's feelings about fairness, being that how do I feel about the pay I receive in relation to my efforts, in relation to my results. In general, we see that pay for performance is having a good impact on performance. So it's a positive story. However, there are two very important elements you should take into account. First of all is the element of procedural justice that can really make or break the functioning of pay for performance. What is procedural justice about? Well, in fact, it's about the possibility that individuals have to utter their grievances, to appeal, to say, well, I'm not feeling very well with the decision that was being taken. The second one is, are they being involved in setting their targets? Is it being discussed? Is the feedback being given, and so on? And also a third element here is the consistent application of the procedures, which should help that for that feeling of procedural justice. A second important element you should take into account is that it is very important to, let's say, have a balanced approach towards results. So not only the individual results should drive pay for performance, but also collective results, being either the results of the team, the department, or the company as a whole. And which collective results to be taken into account, that again depends on the structure and the strategy of the organization.